So I'm a North Shore guy, but I'm very proud of my roots in Revere. Spent a lot of time here growing up. As a kid, used to run up and down here all the time, but also work nearby at Kelly's, you know, when I graduated from high school. Just a really tight-knit, working-class neighborhood. Nobody was rich, but we didn't care. You know, it was all about, you know, relationships. It was all about, you know, hanging out with each other. And I was actually also looking out for each other. This is where I went to high school. This is Revere High. I graduated in 1980. I got burned out a little bit in my senior year, so I decided to take a gap year, which served me well and let me know that some of the types of jobs that I was working at was not what I wanted to do the rest of my life. So my cousin Debbie was a graduate of UMass Amherst in engineering, spoke very, very highly of the school. I visited her one summer when she was living up there, and I fell in love with the campus. It's so much so that it was the only school that I actually applied to. So I got admitted, and the rest is history. Once I got into the School of Engineering, I knew it was the place for me. Dr. Russell taught a class in automated control systems, which for mechanical engineering students at UMass was the most challenging. It was the hardest course. And couple that with, he was probably the hardest grader, but he also taught me the importance of first principles. As an engineer, you know, that's the table stakes. If you do that in a high quality way, that serves you well as an engineer, no matter what, you know, line of business you go into. The journey to Apple was an interesting one. At the time, they were moving more towards the importance of design in their products. So I saw for that part of it, I could be a great partner to go off and make all of this real. The first product I was responsible for was a product called the iMac. When it came out, it was a revolutionary product, not just for Apple, but it was the first really from the grounds up internet-based computer, internet-based Mac. It really showed in a high-quality way that we were a world-class design company as well. I found that, you know, at my job at Apple, I never really considered it a job. I considered it an honor to be there, working with some of the best and brightest in the world, but most importantly, because of the fact that I leveraged my learnings at UMass, and what I picked up when it comes to leadership has carried me forth into a career and a life that I wouldn't change with anyone.
So what are we working on, folks?
Well, this is the Human Robot Systems Lab.
The thing that I got most from my time at UMass is that students who have a desire to be engineering leaders haven't had things handed to them. They've worked really hard and scraped and developed a trait that I prize most in folks when it comes to leadership is the word grit, stick-to-itiveness, and first and foremost, are not only smart, but really, really hard workers.
It doesn't happen all the time, where what you actually go to school for, you actually use every day, and it's fantastic.
Rolling up your sleeves, working the long hours, being the first one in the morning, last one out in the afternoon, the ones that, even when they leave the office, are still obsessed by what they do.
From a capacity perspective, how many parts do you make a month?
As a young engineer, probably my number one piece of advice is to go off and find your passion.
Are you an undergraduate or graduate student?
Undergraduate.
Okay. Really?
If you do so, you know, you're going to go off and not only have a great life and a great career, but you're going to find yourself in a position to go off and make a difference. And every day is going to be a gift.